So what we were trying to do was find a way to prevent the progression of kidney disease. A lot of people with diabetes do progress on to get kidney disease, 30 to 40%. And it's now become the most common reason why people end up on dialysis. And around the world, we are overflowing in every dialysis unit. So we were trying to put a step on that. There was some promising data from SGLT2s from the early studies. We knew they reduced the albumin in the urine. Now, that's a good marker for kidney risk, but in itself, it's not an endpoint. It's not what patients care about. So we took that data and with that designed a study that was specifically designed to test whether these agents would help protect the kidney. And so to do that, we needed people at high risk of kidney disease. And so we specifically recruited people who already had evidence of kidney damage, and we recruited from around the world. The other thing was we really wanted to know that this was an addition to current care, not a replacement. So we mandated that everyone in the study was already on renin-angiotensin blockade. Now, they're agents that we found 2 decades ago, and they do slow the progression of kidney disease, but there's still a lot left over. A lot of people still progress. And so we mandated that everyone would be on those agents, and then we tested whether SGLT2 in addition would help protect the kidney. So that's how we set the study up. We started in 2014 before any of the cardiovascular outcome trials had reported. So at that point, we didn't know what the benefits would be for cardiovascular protection. We recruited these patients and followed them. And then after the cardiovascular outcome studies showed benefit for the heart, we were coming up to our interim analysis, and after that, the Data Monitoring Safety Committee advised that we stop the study for efficacy, because the agent worked. So then we pulled everyone back, took them off study treatment and closed out the study and analysed the results. And what we saw was that canagiflozin reduces progression of kidney disease by about 30 to 34% across the board. The really exciting thing was it also helps The exciting thing is that in a post-hoc analysis, we saw that it reduced the need for dialysis and transplantation or renal death. Now, this is the first study ever that I know of that's been able to show that impact on that income, that outcome. The cardiovascular protection was there for people with kidney disease as well. This is an agent that has to be filtered by the kidney to get to its site of action, so there was plausibility that maybe they wouldn't work in people with reduced kidney impairment. We didn't find that. It works just as well in people with reduced kidney function. And that's important because they have more cardiovascular events than other people. So it's good for the kidney, good for the heart, and no real safety concerns.